Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining me today. It's Alan Barry Labuchan here. I'm with the Alan Barry Reports, and I'm also the CEO of Advanced Gold, AAX on the venture, which is very active down in Mexico. Basically, is a sponsor of everything I do as far as market commentary. I wanted to get started today talking about some trends that I'm seeing. I've been seeing a very positive bull market for gold in the last year. Basically, you know, I mean, a lot of people are talking about it, and we're seeing basically a perfect storm for gold to go higher. You've got central bankers printing money, issuing debt. The debt levels at the federal and household levels all over the world are quite dramatic right now. And then you've got political turmoil all over the place. And now the COVID situation has caused a lot of consternation as well. So it really is a perfect storm for gold to go higher. Last June, we were trading, let's say, at around a little under 1,300. On Friday, we closed at 1,784. So that's a pretty substantial move. I think this next year you're going to see another market like this one you're seeing on the screen, starting at the lower left and ending at the upper right, a very bullish trend. Higher lately, we kind of been the last 3 months or so since about April, we had been going kind of sideways, and then the sideways action really narrowed, and I was expecting a breakout. And we saw that breakout after the tightening of the spread. It's moved up quite nicely. I think we're probably within days of going well into the 1800s. What is also very encouraging is I'm starting to see a lot of the juniors that I followed in the report starting to make significant breakouts. Golden Goliath, GNG on the venture, is one that I recently picked. As you can see, it in around the early part of June, it was trading at under a dime. Friday had a big breakout. It's been having breakouts for about the last 2 weeks, let's say. Week and a half, 2 weeks. And now it's trading at 18. What's really moving this market is they're a closeology play to Great Bear. Great Bear has been, the stock has just been on fire of late. I think it's pretty overcooked these days could be seeing a somewhat of a correction, which would probably bring something like a Golden Goliath down. I'm not saying go out and chase it at 18, 20 cents here. These gaps need to fill. I think the first fill would probably be around 13 cents and then touch, maybe get down to the around the dime. Probably not. 13 is probably a good entry point. So that's one you want to keep an eye on for the action. Another stock that's been really of late, another one that I follow is GWM. GWM has Galway. Has a very good project that they've been putting good news on. They had their Golden Cross back in February earlier this year, and now it just keeps making, since May, it's been making higher highs and higher lows, which is a very positive bull trend to me. This 78 cent spike here just in the last, up to 78 cents in the last couple of days, I probably expect to see somewhat of a pullback on that to fill the gap in between 55 and 78. So somewhere around 60 cents, I think, would be a really good entry point for Galway. They've got good projects, good drill results, good people involved, and they've raised some serious money of late. So they're one of the ones that I picked that have recently had a pretty significant breakout. Amex Gold, I've been a big fan of Amex since about a year and a half ago. I've started following it in my reports, and and commenting on. It was trading at around 50 cents then. It's traded now $2.42 on Friday. It's had a nice breakout. I picked, I had a show with Kelly Malcolm recently. And after that, the stock has been on a nice little tear. Kelly was able to come in and give us some good color on the exploration work that they've done. Some of the news that they've had out recently is they closed a big bought deal financing with Eric Sprott as a big investor in that. Then they added six drill rigs. Then they announced some drill results, which I think were quite important in that these are some of the ones that are, when I first started following it in the early holes, I thought that there was, looked like the zones in these veins were going to connect at depth. And now they're starting to deep drill some of those deep holes. And sure enough, it looks like that's what happened. And so the stock's been ripping of late. And this is one that I think is one of the best junior exploration companies out there with a major high-grade gold discovery in Canada. It's in Quebec. It's got road access. And even at these valuations, I still think that with a re-rating in the price of the gold, that, you know, because there's so few of these high-grade gold discoveries out there, that you could see a much higher valuation. So look for entry points on any kind of weakness on this one, because I think they've got a great story and are going to continue to do very well. Another one that's been that I've been watching lately or for, I think, few months is VZLA, Vizsla, like the dog, Vizsla Resources. And they just, as you can see here, went straight up from 45 cents to 79 cents, creating quite a significant gap. What caused that is they hit some high-grade silver, over a kilogram per ton kind of silver numbers, but it also had high-grade gold in there as well. So that's a heck of a good combination. It's in Mexico. They basically got a whole jurisdiction, and now we're seeing it go through a golden cross here with the 50-day about to move through the 200-day. And so I think that this is another one you want to look at. Any weakness on this one, try to get in there. We've been talking about it a lot lately, and it's moved up quite nicely. I think they've got a lot more blue sky ahead of them. A whole district with high-grade gold and silver, and they're finding new discoveries on that property. So it looks like they might have a new cluster of veins with this high-grade material in it. And so watch that one closely. I think you'll see a lot of good stuff out of them. Okay, so those were what I did with those ones. That was sort of a update on past picks that have recently broken out, and I wanted to sort of give you some color on where I thought we might see some action where you could look at it on the pullback. Now I'm going to get into some picks that I like. One of them that I want to talk about is my own company, Advanced Gold. I'm a very large shareholder in this, so bear that in mind, and there's some bias, I believe. But the bias is based on reality of what we're doing. Right now, we have 39 million shares full issued and a $3.7 million market cap. As you can see here in the chart, we've been, since around April, we kind of bottomed out there at around 6.5 cents. And lately, it's been trending upwards. And I think that that new optimism is relating to some drilling that we're about to start fairly soon. What's exciting about that drilling, on June the 1st, I announced a big, we put out a big news release on what we've done and the keys to where we're going next. And as you can see on the screen now, this is an IP chargeability anomaly. It's over 3,500 meters, which is a big continuous chargeability anomaly. It's not patchy and in and out like a lot. We started drilling over here, 13th, 14th, and 15th, our 13th, 14th, and 15th hole, which were the first three to touch this geophysical anomaly. We hit multiple lenses, stacked lenses of disseminated sulfides, and we had some from low grade to prominent high grade in those first few holes. But again, it's in the disseminated massive sulfide. So what you're not really looking for the lens. Why we drilled over here is, as you can see, it comes very close to surface there, much closer to surface than over here. So we wanted to test this area over here before we go much deeper over here, which is about 3,500 meters away. There's a couple of things that I would like to show you that I think are quite important. One is, as you get over to this area where a hinge zone starts, that it starts to widen quite substantially from the tightness over here. So you've got a wider zone as you go into the area where it looks like the rocks would be more amenable to massive sulfides over thick intersections. The fact that you're getting sulfides with grade in it way over here is a pretty good indicator about what's going to happen when you start drilling into what looks like the plumbing system of what got those sulfides way over there. We're planning a hole to start about here, and we'll be cutting across, maybe it's over here, and we'll be cutting across these zones to test this hinge zone. And then the next step after that, once we see what we got in the hinge zone, we'll want to start drilling deeper and following this system down to depth. These sulfide systems can get quite large. Around 12 miles from us is the San Nicolas mine held by Teck, and it's about 100 million tons, which puts it in the not quite in the largest of the world class deposits of sulfide systems, but it's very big. You know, the average I think is about 20 million tons, 15 million tons, or something like that. So we're in the elephant country for these VMS deposits. These VMS deposits generally come in clusters. So far, there's only been one found, and I think we've got a pretty promising story once we start drilling into this hinge, which I think will be we'll get underway pretty soon here. So keep an eye on my advance. I think it's there's a possibility of a game-changing situation once we drill into this big anomaly over here, where it bends and then dips down beyond the limits of the geophysical survey. So it's getting very exciting for us, and I think you want to take a look, close look at Advance these days. Another pick I wanted to talk about is Callinex Mines. Callinex Mines is a super tight stock. It only has 10.6 million shares out, currently has a $10 million valuation. I'm going to pull up the website here. Some of the news releases that they've had just recently, January 23rd or June 23rd, Callinex identifies highly conductive anomalies on known mine horizons in Flin Flon mining district of Manitoba, a very well known area for VMS deposits. These guys are looking for, it's elephant country. They're looking for elephants. They also had a news release out on June the 15th that caught my attention. Callinex discovers 28.6 meters of 56 grams of silver, including 16.4 meters of 94 grams of silver near surface at their Nash Creek project in Bathurst Mining District of New Brunswick. That's a very good start to a silver discovery. It's not really ore grade type, some of it is, but mostly it's starting to look quite interesting. This is a very strong team of people involved with this company. They know what they're doing when it comes to exploration. Really super tight stock. So, follow that one closely. You want to watch the trends on that one, because it can move quite aggressively with only that little amount to stock out and the quality of projects that they have. It's not just those two, they have other projects as well. So keep a close eye on them when they're drilling. Look for any weakness to take a position in that one. I like the whole situation with CNX is their symbol. and they trade on the Venture Exchange. As you can see in the stock here, it's recently gone through a cup. Now it's creating a bit of a handle, and I think the next trend will be to the upside on that one. The next pick I have for you is a pick that I talked about earlier as being a breakout, but I like this project and the quality of the results that they've recently come out with in this new series of veins that they found could really be a game changer in an area where they've already got mills. It's sort of a district area play. They've got lots of good lots of good targets on their large land package. They got milling equipment. They still have to make a decision if they want to purchase the whole kit and caboodle, which comes with a pretty decent price tag. But the way these guys are going, I definitely think that they can fund this at an attractive valuation. And right now they've got 59 million shares out, $46 million market valuation. Hard to find really good silver projects, especially with gold kicker, or I don't know which way to look at it, high grade gold with a high grade silver kicker, whichever way you want to look at it. It's very exciting. Here's the headline from that June 24th news release. Vizsla drills 1,544 grams of silver over 8.2 meters. If you dig deeper into that result, you also see that they drilled 11 grams of gold in that as well. They had some 24 gram hits of gold, 9.2, 8 grams, 450 grams of silver, some really juicy numbers. And what makes it super exciting is these are new discoveries on the project. We're not even talking about the known veins on the project. So it looks like they might be on to a new cluster of promising high-grade veins that could just be a major breakthrough for the project. So VZLA is their stock symbol. VZLA is their stock symbol. And as you can see, the stock has bottomed out here, starting to create the right side of the cup. I think it might have some more blue sky here before it goes sideways and then a pop much higher. And I can see plenty of catalysts for this company. The next company I want to talk about today is Contact Gold. Contact Gold, as you can see, the last few months, the stock's been in a pretty tight range, right around this 14 cent price. They have 95 million shares out with a $13 million valuation. What makes this interesting is it's a oxide project, oxide gold, where they just did some gold recoveries and they got back very promising numbers. First of all, they get some promising numbers on the for an oxide discovery. Anything, you know, around a half a gram or so is pretty exciting, especially when you're getting 92 to 100% recovery. They're looking for a heap leach kind of operation, big tonnage. It's in an area where Gold Standard Ventures has made some big discoveries. And it looks like they're in a good area for these kind of deposits. And now they're getting some promising bottle roll testing on the metallurgy and very good recovery. So keep an eye on them. I think you'll see lots of catalysts for Contact. As you can see, the stock has really been in a tight range of late. And I think that the next move is to the upside for these guys. And just look for more drilling results, more drilling news. And I think you'll see some good stuff happening for that company. And the final company today of the picks is Dios. Dios Exploration, their symbol is DOS. They've got 89 million shares out, $14 million valuation. They've really come out of the doldrums. If you look back here in early back in December, trading at under 6 cents, and lately they've really come to life. And what's brought them to life is that they're in close proximity. Well, they've got a whole series of really good projects, but some of their projects are in close proximity to Azimut, AZM. And AZM has really been catching the market's attention of late and bringing lots more attention to Quebec exploration and precious metals. And Dios has some key projects near them and also has other good projects and are run by a really good team of people that understand exploration. They spent a fair bit of time in diamond exploration, which is one of the hardest things to look for. I know that intimately because I spent a good chunk of my career, probably 15 years, in diamond exploration. And I see a lot of the people that have left the diamond exploration are doing good things in the gold and precious metals exploration. And Dios definitely fits into that category. And then they've got some good action of late because of their closeness to AZM. They're going to be active in their Elmer area with their K2 project. This is a very interesting project that I've talked about in the past. What I like about this is they've got some good work been done on the geophysics, and now they're sort of tying up the drill targets to get drilling there. And I think you could see some really good stuff out of DOS on the exchange where on the venture where they could really be looking for a much higher valuation. Not saying an Azimut type of evaluation, but definitely could be going in the right direction, that's for sure. So there's some updates, there's some new picks. Again, I'm gonna go close off on the gold chart here. After this sideways action, as I said, I was expecting a breakout. We got that breakout. We now had a higher high than this last high that happened in early April. And the real key part of the sector, the gold sector, that I think is the exploration side of things. We need a lot more discoveries. Mines are getting mined out. Those mines are having lower head grades. The new discoveries are lower grade. There's not a lot of those special high grade discoveries like an Amex has. And we need more of those. We need more low grade, big tonnage deposits, something like what Contact is looking at. And we just need a lot more quality exploration. I mean, there's a lot of companies that call themselves gold exploration companies or silver exploration companies or base metal exploration companies. And really what they are is lifestyle companies that are more interested in paying their people salaries than they are putting drill holes in the ground. And a good way to sort of differentiate for that is to look at the share count. The share count always tells a big story about what the management, how the company is run and what they feel about the company. I think my company, AMEC, or Advanced Gold, is a perfect example. I'm a big shareholder on a fully diluted basis. I own somewhere around 10% of the company. And our chairman, he's in probably around 20% on a fully diluted basis. So the two key people running the company have big chunks of stock. And that's why we have around 40 million shares out, which is one of the lowest counts of all the companies that I follow. And again, I think that you want to look at that share count to give you an idea. Are these lifestyle companies that are more interested in paying wages to their people than they are in putting holes in the ground? This business, the exploration business, is all about making discoveries. You got to be putting holes in the ground to do that. There's not a huge amount of companies that are actually real exploration companies. And with the price of gold, I think about to go a lot higher, there's going to be a new audience of people coming into the sector. And when they do, they're not going to find a big menu of companies to choose between. So you want to beat the crowd to those cheap deals. I cover a lot of them in the reports. Keep an eye on all the stuff I work on. On that note, I'm going to end the show and say, as always, the show is based on is for research or for And for information purposes only, it's important for you to do your homework and speak with your financial advisors before making any investment decisions. And the biggest thing I can say is it's all about the homework. Do your homework, look for companies that are busy with the drill rig. And I think if you find the quality ones, you're going to, this next bull market in gold is going to create a lot of wealth, and you can join that party by sticking to the drill plays and the good tight stock structures. On that note, have a great day, and we will talk to you soon.